played Jesus Christ in our musical Godspell. And as some of you may well know, that is Father Vershak's favorite musical. I was asked to come in today and sing a song called Beautiful City.
For those who didn't see this Godspell, there's two things I'd like to point out. One is interesting to set context for this. How are red ribbons used in this musical?
So for each moment where Jesus Christ made a connection to one of his followers, he would hand them a red ribbon, and that in a sense would include them into the community throughout the course of the show.
And then how were they used at the end?
And at the end they were hung up on a fence to show the cohesion of the family.
And he's also crucified with the red ribbons tied to the fence too, wasn't he?
Yes.
So that's one thing that Kurt, who's not here today, came up with. The other thing was the use of this song, Beautiful City, which he's about to sing, isn't part of the original Broadway show. It was written for the musical when it was turned into a movie. It's often used as an encore as the start of the second act, but Kurt had this idea, and I want to just kind of give him the due he deserves, the praise, because he's better than anyone knows in this school. He's a master teacher with the Missouri Fine Arts Academy. We're lucky to have him here. And he took on Godspell, and he had to sell it to us because most of us, including me, was like, oh, I don't want to do Godspell again. He said, don't worry, I've got a new idea. So it was under his direction, also the amazing cast, that this song came there. So Beautiful City, what happens right before Beautiful City?
Right before it is when Jesus is praying in the garden, and he's basically asking his Father to not let him be crucified, to let this cup pass him by. And this is basically his realization of why he needs to do this, and he begins to see the future for his people.
Start learning how we can build
of angels, finally.